Hello and welcome. Good evening. You're watching NDTV. I'm Sarah Jacob. For people living in the National Capital Region, the weekend began on an unwelcome note as swarms of locusts thronged the region, particularly invading Gurgaon. Now take a look at some of these visuals of fast-spreading swarms of crop-destroying desert locusts that were filmed across Gurgaon, right next to the national capital, Delhi. There were multiple videos. Take a look at those skies there, shot by residents of Gurugram city and villages in this district this morning, show massive clusters of these locusts flying about outside their homes, outside windows. Locusts could be seen hovering over homes and offices in the urban areas of Gurugram. Like you can see them counter, you can see their images opposed to those beautiful skyscrapers and these tall towers. Locusts could be seen there in these offices in the urban areas of Gurugram. Residents of Gurugram were forewarned to keep their doors and windows shut. This attack of locusts is extremely damaging for the farmers of Haryana. Massive swarms of desert locusts have been destroying crops in many parts of western and central India, spearing into Maharashtra, UP, Punjab, and now Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, and Haryana.
शाम को कल ये महेंद्रगढ़ से एंटर किया हरियाणा में और हमारे अधिकारियों ने इसको फॉलो किया और रात के 7 और 8 बजे के बीच में ये सेटल हो गया जाटूसाना के आसपास गांव में, 10-12 गांव में। हमने पूरी तैयारी की, हमारे डिप्टी कमिश्नर पूरी रात वहां पर रहे और अधिकारी जो 7 डिप्टी कमिश्नर रहते हैं तो जिला के पूरे अधिकारी भी रहते हैं। सर्च लाइट का हमने इंतजाम करवाया, 15 फायर ब्रिगेड मंगवाए और पूरी रात जो पेड़ों पे जितनी भी टिड्डियां बैठी थी उनको, काफ़ी लगभग 1/3 टिड्डियों को मारने में हम सफल हुए। जिस क्योंकि सारी बारिश का मौसम है, खेतों के अंदर गिल्ली थी, वहां मशीन नहीं जा सकती थी, लेकिन काफ़ी अच्छी सफलता मिली है।
उसकी एक छोटी सी टुकड़ी दिल्ली के बॉर्डर पर जसोला घाटी की तरफ जो है इंटर की है, हमारे उस वहाँ पर वन विभाग का पूरा क्षेत्र है, तो उसको देखते हुए अभी तुरंत जो है वन विभाग को डायरेक्शन दिया गया है वहाँ पर ढोल बजाने का, ड्रम बजाने का और डीजे बजाने का, जो कि मेजर्स हैं जिससे कि वो टिड्डी दल भागते हैं, निर्देश दे दिया गया है। साथ ही साथ वहाँ पर केमिकल के छिड़काव के भी निर्देश दिए गए हैं। साउथ डिस्ट्रिक्ट और वेस्ट डिस्ट्रिक्ट और साउथ वेस्ट, इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट के डीएम को ये डिविजनल कमिश्नर के माध्यम से डायरेक्शन दी गई है और इन डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स को हाई अलर्ट पे रखा गया है।
Alright, let's go across Saurav Shukla for more on this. So Saurav, the government has and put out an advisory about what one needs to do in the face of the swarm of locusts and the locust attack, as it's being called. What does this advisory say? That's what everybody is interested in. And also the other question on everybody's mind is, we were expecting this morning that, you know, after Gurugram, the locusts would be heading to Delhi, the national capital. Is that no longer the case? Or can we, should we be prepared for something tomorrow?
So for now, Absera, the threat of these locusts is not there in Delhi NCR because wind direction is towards Rajasthan. So the swarm, the biggest swarm of this locust has moved towards Palwal and then towards Rajasthan. So for now, threat is not there. But still, in the morning, around 10:30, as we have been reporting, as you have said, that the swarms of locust was there in Gurgaon. In fact, the visuals of Cyber City was quite, people were very afraid, and advisory was already there in Gurugram that people should close their windows and doors, and the people who have garden inside their home, they should spread chemicals to protect the plants. So as of now, one cluster of locusts moved towards Delhi also. So it was there around 12:30 in the afternoon in the area of Chhatarpur. So there's no report of damages in Gurgaon and in NCR, in Delhi also. But cluster of locusts was seen in Greater Noida, in Dadri area of Greater Noida. But the biggest cluster of locusts has moved towards Rajasthan because the wind direction is towards that side. But as of now, the threat also remains, because if the direction of wind changes, then they may move towards Delhi NCR as well. So that is why in the afternoon, Environment Minister of Delhi, Gopal Rai, held a meeting with officials, and the advisory is that people should stay indoors, close their windows and doors, and for the farmers especially, so as soon as they see these locusts in the sky, they should start making noises, they should bang utensils. Apart from that, they can play loud music through DJs so they don't land in the ground and destroy the crops. So as of now, threat remains, and it has moved towards the chunk. The biggest chunk of locusts has moved towards Rajasthan. So, there'll be a challenge in front of Rajasthan government and in front of farmers to how to tackle with these people. In fact, though Rajasthan was in high alert several days back. In fact, I was talking to one official in Haryana. So there are reports of crop damages in Rewari, Jhajjar district of Haryana, though Agriculture Minister of Haryana is saying that he is going to be there. They will assess the damage and they are going to compensate farmers. So as of now, there's one good news for the people staying in Delhi and in NCR, that locusts have moved towards Rajasthan and other parts of UP because wind direction is towards that side. But advisory still remains. People should stay indoors. As soon as they see locusts, they should close their doors and windows. And for the farmers, they should start banging utensils. They should start making noise. So though, because they usually fly over the sky around 100 feet above ground, so they should not land in ground and destroy the crops.
All right, thanks, Saurav, for that. So, hashtag locust attack has been dominating social media trends as swarms of locusts invaded Gurgaon. What is this locust swarm about? There have been scary videos and photos of this locust attack that have flooded social media sites. People are worried about how to tackle it. These trends have been dominating Twitter in India today, and most of these users are sharing videos. Some have been trying to gain some respite with jokes and memes, but the underlying fact is that everyone is concerned. What is going on? What is this about? What does this portend? What do we need to do to protect ourselves, if anything? So we have put together for you on the show tonight, Dr. Sunita Narayan. She's the director of the Center of Science and Environment. We have S.N. Sushil, a principal scientist at the Indian Council of Agricultural Research. He's an entomologist and the former plant protection advisor at the Agriculture Ministry. And we have Parvez Damania, former executive director at Kingfisher Airlines. He's an aviation expert, well-known face on NDTV. Dr. S.N. Sushil, I want to start with you. You know, there is so much anxiety about these locust swarms. I know I looked it up today. So let me ask you first, as an entomologist, you know, questions on Twitter, etc. Locusts don't attack people, right? And they do they? We're living in the time of coronavirus. So one question on people's minds are, what does this mean? Do they carry diseases that could harm humans, for example?
No, as per, there is no report saying that it is a pest of human. No, as per, there is no report word over. So we should not panic for that.
At the maximum, if they come to your home, it may irritate you, sort of. So only thing is, you have to close the windows and close the doors, and maybe net and all you can use. And but basically, they are the immature adults. They are moving in search of food. So whatever we saw today, they were actually coming from the yesterday night in Rewari and Jhajjar area, whatever operations they made. So after that leftover population, they moved following the wind direction towards the NCR. And okay, Now they have moved towards the Bulandshahr, not this side, but they have moved towards Bulandshahr. So,
okay. So that's certainly, yeah, First and foremost, good to clarify that. That is good news. But of course, as you say, as long as you're in your homes, what about people who don't have homes? And what about the farmers? Because farmers face with a double whammy. Their lives are threatened by the coronavirus and their livelihoods now by locusts. How much of damage does a locust infestation actually do? What is the scale of the problem here?
Yeah, if they settle down in any field, certainly they will eat out almost everything. So for that, the government of India has recommended 11 formulations of pesticide that can be used immediately. And already there is a locust warning organization working very well, doing their job very well. And there is state government machinery also working together. So I think jointly they are managing so far more than 55 swans came in India from the, because it's a transboundary place, they are not originated from India, they are coming from the other part of the border. So they are coming from that side, and these team they are controlling. If any farmer, if he finds that there is a settlement of swans in the field, they can immediately report to the nearest agriculture department or state government or a locust warning organization. I think they will do the operation for them. But if the person himself want to manage, already there are pesticides which are recommended, and that should be used in a correct dose, and also using all the protective gears.
All right, Mr. Sushil, you say the government is handling this very well, but the question is, why are we here in a position to have to handle it? Sunita Narayan, we are having a locust attack for the first time in 30 years, from what I've understood. Certainly, I haven't seen this in the past decade, at least being in Delhi. We've heard it being reported in parts of Rajasthan, but not in UP and in Delhi, mowing down thousands of hectares of crops, creating a possible food crisis, even as we're trying to deal with COVID-19 and we're living through a pandemic. What is actually going on here environmentally?
See, Sarah, let's be very clear that the locust attack has actually been happening for the last 2 years. Almost, and it's just growing in virulence, because this is a creature which grows exponentially. And what has happened in the last 2 years is that you have already seen the link with climate change and cyclones. You're getting an intensification of cyclones in the region.
You've seen already, I think, three this year.
Yes, absolutely. And what you saw was actually very unusual cyclones in 2018 and 2019 in the Arabian Peninsula. Now, these are creatures of the desert, so they live and die in the desert. But when in the desert they have got rainfall, they have essentially got the right environment for them to breed. And they breed exponentially. And as a result of it, they have just grown, and they moved from the Arabian Peninsula to the Horn of Africa and across Iran to Pakistan and then to Rajasthan and Gujarat. Now, even in India last year, we had an extended monsoon also linked to climate change. And as a result of it, the extension of the monsoon meant the locusts never returned back. So you've had these swarms of locusts which have been breeding and exponentially. And please understand, the threat is really not in cities. The threat is on the livelihood of farmers. When the locusts were attacking a few months ago, farmers' fields were largely barren. But now is when they're going to be planting. Mm-hmm. Now is when the devastation will be massive. There is also, and two more things that I want to add here. One, that there is now a talk about the Horn of Africa, which is the maximum, where the maximum damage is happening because of locusts. FAO has predicted that you will see with the wind, because the locusts travel with the wind, that they will move across from the Horn of Africa, across the Arabian Sea, and there'll be new swarms coming into India. And the fact of the matter is, the locusts are like climate change. This is where FAO needs to step up its act, just like WHO. Took so long in declaring corona as a pandemic, FAO today is humming and hawing whether it should declare it as a plague. It needs to make sure that it can get governments the assistance it requires, and there needs to be far more attention to the problem of locusts.
Okay, so unlike Mr. Sushil, you're saying the response is not enough. We should expect worse, and I'm guessing with the monsoons. Let me ask you, before I get to the monsoons, Sunita, one of the outcomes, the fallout of this pandemic, of the lockdown, has been that environmentally we have been able to breathe, especially in the National Capital Region. For a few months, we could finally see blue skies again. We could hear a bird song.
Yeah.
When you see the government's response, where they say play high volume music, burn firecrackers, burn neem leaves, and a lot of use of insecticides, is this environmentally counterproductive? Because on one hand, also because of the pandemic, what we've seen a huge setback to the whole campaign against the use of single-use plastics.
Absolutely.
We've been set back by maybe over a decade when it comes to that. Now with this locust attack, what are we doing? Are we countering it the right way? Or will this now lead to other problems going forward?
You know, Sarah, we live in really confounding times. And this is where we have to understand that, you know, on the one hand, as you rightly say, we saw blue skies. We had the chance to breathe easy. But on the other hand, we have seen today both that public transport is not on our roads because of the fear of the virus. We're using so much more plastic. And as far as locusts are concerned, I have really tried to understand this. And my understanding is that at this moment, at the scale of the plague kind of situation that we are looking at, there is no other option but to spray the pesticides. Oh, because there is no other scale, at the scale that the attack is, there's nothing we could do. We should have done it when they were breeding. We need to stop them from breeding. We need to have far more targeted action. And my hope is that this, you know, bringing them to Delhi, bringing them to Gurgaon gets at least the attention that we need. I mean, CSE has been talking about this. I wrote this in January saying, we in India know about the bushfires in Australia, but we don't know about the locust attack in Rajasthan and Gujarat.
We'll certainly be covering it a lot more, like you said, now that they're on the borders of the national capital. Unfortunately, many will be guilty of that. But, you know, one of the issues that concern people, let me get Parvez Dhamania in over here. Mr. Dhamania, Delhi's international airport, which borders Gurgaon, home to one of the world's top corporations, some of the world's top corporations, they've asked pilots now to take extra precautions during takeoff and landing due to locusts. Is this an area for concerns? Flights have restarted. You know, people's worried about flying in the time of a pandemic in this coronavirus. And now do we also need to be worried about locust swarms?
No. I think this is a very serious problem. And we need to look at this very seriously. DGCA has already passed a circular that pilots need to be very careful while takeoff and landing, because this is a very serious concern. You see, in the past, in January, an Ethiopian Airways airline turned back because they flew into locusts and the entire windshield was covered, and it became a dangerous situation and they had to turn back the aircraft. You see, these swarms can be 1 square kilometer to many, many square kilometers, okay? And each square kilometer is about 40 million insects. So definitely one has to be very careful. And the pilots, even if they pass through a locust storm, they have to report immediately. Plus the other problem is even when these aircrafts are parked on ground, there's certain precautions that have to be taken while maintaining the aircraft so that these do not get in the engine. And if it gets into the engine while taking off landing, it could be a very serious concern. See, already the problem is, the locust problem has already come to Punjab, Gujarat, Maharashtra and MP. So one will have to be careful, and the DGC is keeping a watch on the situation, that's for sure.
So have they urged airlines not to fly during a locust invasion? Because as you're saying, and this is also going to get worse, as Sunita and our expert as the ICAR are pointing out, because the monsoons are going to hit India soon, 10 days early, I'm told.
No, there is no directive not to fly. But the thing is, they've just made sure that extra care is taken while taking off and landing. And if they pass through a locust storm, then they have to report it. That is the thing. So just one is to take extra precautions, and one is to see these locusts are at a lower height. So while taking off and landing is where the serious problem is, once the plane has achieved a greater height.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Mr. Dhamania, for explaining that in simple terms for our audience. Sunita, closing argument to you, what does one need to do both as an individual and as the government in the months ahead?
See, the first thing, Sarah, we must understand is locusts do not know any boundary. What we are seeing today is a unique problem in the world, whether it's the virus, whether it is air pollution, whether it is climate change or whether it is locusts, they do not know any national boundaries. So the first thing we need to understand is that we need global cooperation. We need global institutions and we need to talk to each other globally. We cannot do this alone. These locusts are coming from Iran, they're coming from Pakistan, they're going to come across the Horn of Africa. If Horn of Africa does not get assistance, more and more locusts will breed there. More and more locusts will come across with the monsoon winds to India. So global cooperation is critical.
Global cooperation is critical. Thanks, Sunita. And essence, Sushil, sir, last word to you. With the monsoons, we should expect this crisis to get worse?
May not be that worse because of this dry season. This time they came a little early. They came from the 30th April, first song came. Afterwards, continuous 55 songs we got here. But then because of dryness in the Rajasthan area, they moved further to MP or UP or Maharashtra, up to Maharashtra also. But then now in the monsoon season, once there is a greenery, they will restrict their movement and they will not come forward. And also the population which we are getting now, they are all immature stages, they are all fledglings. And see, immature adults, they are not sexually mature. So for egg-laying, they have to go back to Rajasthan. Otherwise, whatever population we are getting this side, they are actually self-dying population. They will have to die. And the population which we got
Sunita,
yesterday...
Sunita, we're completely out of time. You're disagreeing. Just quickly, if you can 30 seconds say why you disagree. And I want to, I have to wind up there.
This entire effort to constantly underestimate the scale of the problem is why we are in the mess today. If the scientists of ICR had got their act together, we would not be in this mess today. Because for the last 1 year, the locust attack is only growing in virulence. So I think
All right.
Underestimating the problem.
All right. Mrs. Sushil, thank you so much. Sunita Narayan, thank you. And Pervez Damania, thank you. Like I said, the story is not going away. I fear we're going to have to focus and talk and debate about this a lot more. Thank you all for your time.